memories that linger of our school days. At Bessbrook School, at Mayo Bridge, St. Patrick's and St. Clair's.
Hurrying to get there for the start of school at 9. Lucky if your shoes were new, not your cousin's hand-me-downs, which pinched you as you walked.
Some of us had satchels, some of us had books tied up with twine. Girls and boys in different classes. A strict headmaster, Mr. Dara. Our teachers were the nuns, and Mrs. Goose and Mrs. Grey.
In geography, a big map of the world pulled down across the blackboard. The teacher then would call you up to point some places out.
The smoky smell of fire in the winter classroom. In the centre of the room, the stage for our nativity plays. Our families came to watch.
I made myself a frock in sewing class. We learnt to knit. Squares for making blankets, socks and scarves. If you had no money for the wool, your ma would wash a jumper, pull it all apart, then wrap the wool around a chair until it was unthreaded and send it into school.
Money also needed for cookery classes in the tech. We picked ripe blackberries to sell at Mr. Blackstorp's shop to make money for the jotters for our classes.
Singing in the choir meant going to Sunday Mass, or the teacher giving off to you for not attending. One day at Mass, that Nessa Smith pulled down my heavy petticoat to raise a laugh or two. It did not make me smile.
At choir practice, Sister Elizabeth said that I was singing out of tune. I said I sang the song the way I thought it should be done. I felt annoyed and told to leave and never to return.
The sounds of school days linger in our memories.
The clanging of the bell when school began at 9, and at start and end of break time, grace time, lunch time, home time.
The scrape of chalk along the blackboard made me cringe. Doing our sums and spellings on small tablets. A crack across the knuckles with a cane for all mistakes.
Break time, and the clatter and the natter in the schoolyard. We played football and rounders. Our marbles clashed together. The Waterloos, the Taws, the Glassies and we dingers. Oh, the shouts of, knuckle your trig and shoot like a pig. The Waterloos, the Taws, the Glassies and we dingers.
The bash of conkers brought to school for competitions. Kept warm to harden them to help your chance of winning.
Skipping in the schoolyard, singing skipping songs. Jelly on the plate. Jelly on the plate goes wibble wobble, wibble wobble, jelly on the plate.
I'm a little Irish girl dressed in blue. Here are the things I like to do. Salute to the captain, bow to the queen. Turn my back on a sombering. I can do the tap dance, I can do the splits. I can do the hokey cokey just like this.
The tastes of school days linger in our memories.
Cool water from lead drinking cups on chains there in the yard.
Or going back home for dinner.
Or munching pieces with our friends.
At 3 o'clock, when school was over.
Buying penny sweets from O'Hagan's.
Or crispy chips and curries for the journey home.
School days.
School days.
School days.
School days.
Linger in our memories. Well, well, Mary McKeown, I should have known I'd find you here at break time. What have you done now?
Nothing, sister.
Oh, Mary McKeown, you must think I've been brought in by the tide if you expect me to believe that Sister Margaret has you doing lines on the blackboard for doing nothing.
Sure, it wasn't even me, sister.
No, Mary, it never is you. You never do nothing. You're the biggest martyr in Mayo Bridge. Have you had your milk yet?
No, sister.
Then take a bottle. And for the mercy of God, sit down and behave.
There's only one left, sister.
Take a bottle.
A and drink it. But sister...
Stop your whining. Take the milk and drink it. We will not have you telling your parents that we are neglecting you in school.
But the top's been pecked by a bird, sister.
And what of it? It won't cause you any harm.
What if I get bird flu, sister? I'll be coughing for weeks, then die.
It'll be more than bird flu that'll kill you if you don't take a seat and drink that milk quietly. Enter. I said come in. Are you hard of hearing? Frank Mulvena, what exactly are you doing in my classroom?
Sister Margaret sent me here.
Please explain why.
I've got trousers on, sister.
So I see, Master Mulvena. And why have you got long trousers on? Do you work in a factory, Master Mulvena? Are you an apprentice, Mulvena?
No, sister.
Then why exactly have you got long trousers on?
I'm sorry, sister. I had to help my dad with the tractor and I got oil on my shorts and my mum put them in the washing basket.
What use are they in a washing basket?
My mum said...
What use?
Cleanliness is close to godliness. And I can't get my shorts back until wash day. And wash day isn't until Tuesday, sister.
Do we allow long trousers in Mayo Bridge School?
No, sister.
Then you'll have to take them off.
But I've got no shorts, sister.
Then see Mr. Henry at the end of break and see if he has a spare pair. Otherwise, you must go home and get changed.
I live an hour and a half away from school, sister.
Well, you should have thought about that before you decided it was a good idea to come into school dressed as a reprobate. Now put your hands out.
I'm sorry, sister.
Sorry? Sorry? Yes, your hand will be very sorry. Your hands are very sorry indeed, but you, Mulvena, are not. Put your palms up. Look, look, look how red they are. They are the palms of a persistent rule breaker. Oh, do you think I could make those any redder?
No, sister.
I will try. I will try so that you will learn how to not break rules. Now, hands out, no excuses. Don't take me for a fool, Mulvena. The left hand, please. I certainly won't be giving you any excuses for not being able to do your written work today. Mary McHugh. Did I ask you to make a sound?
No, sister.
What is that?
A bit of cheese, sister. It fell out of my sandwich when I jumped.
Fell out?
Yes, sister, it fell on the floor.
And are you planning on leaving it there?
No, sister. I was going to pick it up and put it in the bin.
In the bin? In the bin?
Yes, sister.
You were going to put a good bit of cheese in the bin.
It fell on the floor, sister.
There are children starving in this world, and you
We're going to put a good bit of cheese in the bin.
Oh, it has fluff and hers on it, sister.
Eat it.
Eat it?
Put it in your mouth and chew it.
Oh, but sister...
Eat that cheese! Or Mr. Milvena won't be the only one with a red hand. Eat the cheese! And remember to say a prayer to God to thank Him for your blessings.